Late this afternoon, Hamilton County Commissioner struck a deal with the Bengals and the Reds over the stadium tax rollback. And the bottom line, it affects your bottom dollar. News 5's John London is live with the developments. John?
Yeah, Cheryl, instead of a $57 break on your taxes in the coming year, you'll get something like 14 for every 100,000 of assessed value. The Hamilton County wanted the teams to step up, and they did, but some say they used a stool instead of a ladder. If these negotiations with the sports teams were actual athletic events, the fans might never stop booing.
Well, as a taxpayer, I'm very disappointed that the county commissioners are going to be breaking their word to the voters. It seems like that's the one part of the stadium deal that hasn't been corrupted.
The three elected leaders you see here are taking heat for a problem they did not create. But on their watch, the long-ago promise of a permanent tax break is as busted as a broken play on game day. Next year's projected stadium fund deficit is a whopping $16 million. Your property tax bill next year will go hundreds of dollars higher depending on the assessed value of your property. You'll get only 25% of your annual rollback in 2011. Any increase worries those who market the area.
You're talking about people in an extremely difficult economic time who are either limited financially on their own budget, they're out of a job, or they're elderly or combination thereof.
Hamilton County wanted anywhere from $18 to $51 million from each franchise over the next 5 years. They got a grand total of 10. $8 million additional rent from the Bengals, $2 million additional rent from the Reds. It takes care of the immediate problem and leaves long-term to whoever's lucky enough to be elected in the future. Anyone care to sort of sum it up?
The Reds and the Bengals got sweetheart deals. And when you have a sweetheart deal, you have no incentive to renegotiate it.
So here's tonight's triangle. The county avoids fiscal emergency. The teams kick in $10 million with no increase in ticket prices so far. And the homeowner comes away with higher taxes on a broken 14-year-old promise. Reporting live, John London, News 5.